This video is about a 2-qubit gate known as CNOT or control NOT gate. Control NOT gate is like all quantum gate is a unitary gate because every quantum gate has to be unitary. Furthermore, it is also Hermitian. Let's revise quickly that unitary means that CNOT, which is control NOT, times CNOT conjugate transpose is equal to identity, whereas Hermitian means that CNOT, which is control NOT gate, is equal to CNOT conjugate transpose. Because here we are saying that conjugate transpose is inverse, so we are saying here that conjugate transpose is inverse in case of unitary. And here we are saying that conjugate transpose is equal to the original gate. Therefore, from these two statements, we can say that in this case, CNOT is inverse of itself. It implies that if I take a 2-qubit register, because it is a 2-qubit gate, and I apply CNOT on that gate, and then whatever the result I have, I apply CNOT once again on the result, then my answer will be cat x, which was the original input. That means input will remain unchanged because these two CNOT will cancel each other effect. Like the all quantum gates can be expressed in a matrix form, so we can express CNOT gate also in a matrix form. So in a matrix form, CNOT gate in a unitary matrix form is expressed by a 4x4 matrix. And why 4x4 matrix? Let's say you have a single qubit gate. For single qubit gates, you need 2x2 matrix because 2 raised to power 1 is 2. So for single qubit, for 1 qubit, we will need 2 raised to power 1 times 2 raised to power 1 matrix. For 2 qubits, we need a gate which is 2 raised to power 2 times 2 raised to power 2. And similarly for n qubits, we need a matrix which is 2 raised to power n times 2 raised to power n. So because it is a gate for 2 qubits, so represented as a 4x4 matrix. And this matrix is very similar to identity matrix. First two columns are the same as of identity matrix, but the last two columns are swapped. So the first column is 1, 0, 0, 0. Second column is 0, 1, 0, 0. And these two last columns are swapped with each other. So we will have here 0, 0, 0, 1, and we have here 0, 0, 1, 0. So now, why it is called control NOT gate? It is because in general form, in simple form, the first qubit represented as a control bit. And if the first qubit is 1, then it flips the second qubit. If the first qubit is 0, then the second qubit remains the same. Let's see what that means. So in the general form, we can say that this is a representation of CNOT gate, that the first qubit, let's say it was x on input, it will be on the output, it will also be get x. And the second qubit depends upon the first qubit. That means the second qubit is y, then on the output, and we will have x exclusive OR with y. And we know when we do XOR with 0, our result remains the same. We do XOR with 1, our result flips. Let's say I have a CNOT gate and I apply that CNOT gate on 0, 0. Now, because the first qubit is 0, the x qubit is 0, second qubit will remain the same, so our output will be catch 0, 0. If I have a CNOT gate and I apply that CNOT gate on qubits 1, 0. Because the first qubit is 1, so the second qubit will flip. Second qubit will become also 1. So my result is going to be 1, 1. Similarly, if I apply CNOT gate on cat 0, 1, then because the first qubit is 0, my result will be 0, 1. And finally, if I apply CNOT gate on cat 1, 1, then because the first qubit is 1, so my second qubit will flip. So my result is going to be 1, 0. because my aim is that everybody understand quantum computing. So instead of believing me that the results are correct, we should try out one of those results using this matrix and verify if these results are correct. So maybe we should use this one. We should verify this result. So let's do that. Oh, so I have made one mistake here. We should have an exclusive one. So our goal is basically applying a CNOT gate on cat 1-1 and see what will be our result. This matrix represents CNOT gate, and now we have to apply it on cat 1-1. So cat 1-1 is going to be a vector whose third position will have 1 in it. So this is the zeroth position of the vector. This is the first position of the vector. This is the second position of the vector. This is the third position. So this vector represents cat 1-1. So we apply this matrix on this vector and see what will be our result. And because the third position has 1 in it, so our result going to be this last third column, which is 0, 0, 1, 0. Now, because second position has 1, so we have to write 1, 0. That means 2, because second position has 1 in it. We have verified that indeed when CNOT is being applied on cat 1-1, our answer is cat 0-1. So far, we have applied CNOT gate on pure states. That means this was a pure state of 0-0 and our result was a pure state of 0-1. What if we apply CNOT gate not on a pure state but on superpositions? Like maybe we take a cat 0 and apply Hadamard gate, that will create an equal superposition of 0-1, and we apply CNOT gate on that superposition. So let's try that out. So let me clear the board quickly. If we apply Hadamard gate on cat 0, then our answer is cat 0 plus cat 1 divided by scale root of 2, and this is referred to as plus cat plus. Similarly, if we apply Hadamard gate on cat 1, our answer is cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by a scale root of 2, and this is referred to as minus cat minus. So let's say we have a CNOT gate here. So this is our CNOT gate. And instead of giving that gate some pure state, we give it cat plus and cat plus. Then our result is cat plus and cat plus. So let's say if we apply CNOT gate on cat plus, our result is cat plus, if we apply CNOT gate on cat minus plus, our result is minus plus. So the rule is this, in this case, if the second qubit is minus, then the first qubit flips from plus to minus and minus to plus. So in this case, because the second qubit was plus here and plus here, so our result remains the same. But what if our second qubit is minus? That means we have minus minus. Then the first qubit will flip. So we will have plus minus. Similarly, if we have applied CNOT gate on second qubit is minus, first qubit is plus, then our first qubit will flip to minus. So we will have minus minus. Maybe we should also verify one of those results for the sake of our practice. So let's say which one we should verify. Maybe we should verify this one. This one looks difficult because there's flipping and both qubits are minus minus. So let's try this one. So first we figure out that what is cat minus minus. Cat minus minus is equals to cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by a square root of 2 times cat 0 cat 1 divided by square root of 2, and when we simplify it, then we will have 0, 0, because this, and minus 0, 1, we will have then minus 1, 0, And finally, we will have plus 1, 1, divided by square root of 2. Now, because we want to verify it using matrix, so we have to convert this in a form of vector. So in the form of vector, we will have 1 on all of those places, and the signs will be whatever the sign we have. So we will have plus 1 for the zeroth location. We have minus 1 for the first location. We will have minus 1 for the second location. And we have plus 1 for the last location. And we will have 1 over square root 2 outside. So this is our vector. And we have to see if we apply our CNOT matrix on this vector, if our result is equal to this or not. So let's apply CNOT matrix on this vector. Our CNOT matrix is 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0. We apply our CNOT matrix on this vector. We will have 1 over square root of 2 outside. I think we made a mistake. It should be 1 over 2. And then we apply this thing to this, and we will get our 1. We apply this thing to this, we will get minus 1. We apply this to this, we will get 1. We apply this to this, we get minus 1. If our result is correct, if this vector is equals to plus minus, and let's check this out. So we know that plus minus is going to be get 0 plus get 1 divided by square root of 2 times get 0 minus get 1 divided by square root of 2. And if we simplify it, we will get 1 over 2 outside, and inside we're going to get 0 0 minus get. So far we are right, because first location will have plus 1 and we have 1 over 2 outside, and second location going to have get 0 1. So this is 0th location, this is first location. It is indeed minus 1, that this is correct also. Now we multiply this with this, we get plus get 1, 0, and third should be plus 1, this is correct. And the last going to be minus 1, 1, and this is also correct, because the last location will have minus. So we have verified that when we apply CNOT on get minus minus, our result is indeed get plus minus. So we can use CNOT gate and Hadamard gate to create Bell states. And that is the subject of the next video. So I hope that you will stay tuned and watch the next video.